We will start with enzymes. Enzymes are our biological or biocatalyst which catalyze the reaction in the living beings, and we have studied about these enzymes in our surface chemistry also. So enzymes are the catalysts which are working on the living cells, and all enzymes are protein molecules. So all the enzymes are protein molecule, whereas all proteins are not enzyme. Some are simple proteins and they are known as simple enzymes, while the other are your conjugated proteins. This means these conjugated proteins are those enzymes which consist of a non-protein group known as prostatic group. So here we call such enzymes as halo enzymes. Okay, those enzymes having the conjugated proteins are known as halo enzymes, and it consists of the protein part which is known as apoenzyme and a non-protein part which is known as coenzyme. This non-protein part or the coenzyme is very important for the function of this protein part. So coenzymes are the substance necessary for the activity of certain enzymes, and we know how these reactions takes place in enzymes, that they are very specific in reactions, and there is an enzyme substrate complex is formed, and this enzyme substrate complex then convert into enzyme product, and enzyme is separated out from the product then. And we have also studied about the characteristics of the enzymes in our surface chemistry. They are chemical in nature and are complex macromolecule with higher molecular mass. They are very specific to their substrate. They are very specific to the temperature and the pH, and they are very specific. These enzymes are efficiency is more than that of the catalyst, but there are some applications where these enzymes can be used. Enzymes like invertase, zymase and maltase are used in the manufacture of alcoholic drinks. Similarly, enzyme rennin is used in the manufacture of cheese. Maltase is used for the manufacture of malt, which is a basic component of your health drinks. Invertase is used for manufacture of invert sugar, and we have told you that invert sugar is the equimolar mixture of glucose and fructose. There are certain diseases caused by the deficiency of this enzyme. First one is your phenylketonuria, which is caused by the deficiency of phenylalanine enzyme, which is a protein, and this phenylalanine, which is amino acid, get accumulated in the body during the deficiency of this enzyme and leads to the brain damage or mental retardation in children. Next one is your albinism, which is caused due to the deficiency of tyrosinase enzymes. Next we will move toward our nucleic acids, and nucleic acids are very important polymer which are present in all living cells. These are required for the storage and expression of the genetic informations, and they play a vital role in the transmission of heredity character from one generation to another. They also help in the biosynthesis of protein, including enzymes. So nucleic acid are the important polymers in our living cells, and basically nucleic acid are present in our DNA and RNA. The chemical composition of this nucleic acid are nitrogenous base, pentose sugar and phosphoric acid. Now we will move toward the nitrogenous bases are of two type. One is your purine are your six member ring with five member ring fused to it. So here there is six member ring, 1 2 3 4 5 6, and this five member ring is fused in these. There are two types, adenine and guanine, and here are the two structures of this adenine and guanine. Next is your pyrimidine. Pyrimidine are the single six member in heterocyclic ring with two nitrogen atoms present in it. So here one and two nitrogen atoms present in it, and it is six membered cyclic ring. And here comes thymine, cytosine and uracil. Thymine and cytosines are present in our DNA, whereas this thymine is replaced by uracil in our RNA. So in our RNA, cytosine and uracil is present. Next one is your pentose sugar. Pentose sugar are of two type, ribose sugar and deoxyribose sugar. So the difference here is at carbon 2. If a carbon 2 position is having H and OH group, then it is known as ribose sugar. If the carbon at two position have hydrogens are known as your deoxyribose sugar. Then there is the third component is your phosphoric acid having the formula P double bond O, OH, OH and H. So it is your H3PO3 compound, phosphoric acid. Now how these component are arrange in nucleic acid, base are combined with sugar, and whenever base combines with sugar is known as nucleosides. And when this nucleosides, that is base plus sugar plus phosphate, all the three components are present, then it is known as nucleotide. So what is the difference between nucleosides and nucleotides? Base plus sugar in a nucleic acid is known as your nucleoside, and nucleoside plus your phosphate is known as nucleotide. So I have given an example over here. This is your base. Base has been arranged with your ribose sugar. So H and OH is here. So base plus sugar, and this is an example of your nucleoside. When this CH2OH is combined with a phosphate group, yani ki we are having base, we are having sugar, and we are having phosphate group, this is known as your nucleotides. So nucleic acid consists of nucleosides and nucleotides. Next is your DNA. Deoxyribonucleic acids are known as DNA, and DNA consists the genetic material in the form of your codes. So this is the primary structure of DNA. Here consists of two strands of DNA is here. One strand is this, the second one is this. Here the base one has been attached with your sugar. The sugar is attached with the phosphorus. This phosphoric acid then attached with the carbon fifth of the second ribose sugar and deoxyribose sugar, and this one is again there is a base. In this way these two strands are formed. Base one is linked with another strand base one, and they are complementary with each other. This means they are forming hydrogen bonds. Adenine will always form two hydrogen bonds with thymine, and cytosine will form three hydrogen bonds with guanine. It is not that adenine is added to cytosine or guanines. So these base pairing take place by the hydrogen bonds. Now there comes the secondary structure of DNA. Watson and Crick proposed a double helix model of DNA, and DNA molecule consists of two deoxyribonucleoside chain. These are the two deoxyribonucleoside chain. One starts with 5 dash and ends to in a 3 dash end, whereas the other one starts from the 3 dash end and ends at 5 dash ends. So they are spirally coiled around each other, and this coiling of the DNA takes place to the right hand sides on a common axis. The two chains are held together by the formation of hydrogen bonds, again with they are complementary to each other, these two polypeptide chains, and these formation of phosphodiester bond in one chain is 5 dash to 3 dash n, and on the other one it will be 3 dash to 5 dash n. So nucleotides mein the bonding present is your phosphodiester bonding. Whereas in protein we are having peptide linkage, in carbohydrates we are having glycosidic linkage. So in nucleic acid or in DNA we are having phosphodiester linkage. Process is biological function of nucleic acid, and in this importance of nucleic acid we are going to study about replication and protein synthesis. So what is replication? Replication is the process by which a single DNA molecule produces two identical copies of itself. So the process starts by the replication, unwinding of this DNA molecule. This replication in an enzyme catalyzed process, and during this process the DNA molecule partially unwinds, that in which the two strands of the DNA double helix opens up by breaking of the hydrogen bonds between the pairs of bases. Each strand then act as a template, each strand then act as a template or the pattern for the synthesis of the two new strands of DNA in the cellular environment. The specificity of the base pairing ensures that each new strand is complementary to its old template strands. This means that G will always pair with C in the new strand, G, C will always pair with G in the new strands, and so on. As a result, two identical copies, these two identical copies of DNA forms from the original DNA. Each of these two copies are then passed to the new cell, resulting from the cell division. In this way, heredity characters are transmitted from one cell to another. The second one is the synthesis of protein, and this synthesis of protein takes place in two steps. The first one is your transcription. The process which leads to the synthesis of RNA is called transcription. Yani ki when the RNA is produced from DNA is your transcription. So again, there is a partial unwinding of the two strands of the DNA, as I have shown you earlier. Also, the genetic information for the synthesis of the protein exists in the form of base sequence like this: TTA or your GCA. So these are the information based for the synthesis of protein, which are present in the form of base sequence on the two chains of the DNA molecule. These chains is called sense chain. So these two are the sense chain, and because of this sense chain, new chains will be formed. The pair of the base act as a template for the synthesis of the RNA. Now, after the RNA strand is synthesized, the DNA, then again DNA RNA and double helix separate out, and the DNA coiled up to form the DNA structure, and RNA passes into the cytoplasm while the DNA itself returns to the double helix structure. Now the second process occurs, translation. Translation is a process where the RNA synthesizes protein. So it is a process of the synthesis of protein from RNA. So transcription, which we have done earlier, transcription is the process of synthesizing RNA from DNA, and translation is the synthesis of protein from RNA. The RNA, that is ribosomal RNA. Actually, we are having three types of RNA. One is your rRNA, ribosomal RNA. One is your tRNA, transfer RNA. And the another one, third one is your mRNA, that is your messenger RNA. So these rRNA is a component of the ribosome, because these are present on the ribosome, and we know that ribosome synthesize protein. So the specific nucleotide sequence in mRNA determines the order in which the different amino acid has to be joined. Each triplets of the nucleotide is known as codon, which act as a code for the particular amino acid formation, and in this way different amino acids combine together to form protein. Now here are the some differences between DNA and RNA. DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid, and RNA stands for ribose nucleic acid. DNA is called deoxyribose nucleic acid because of the presence of pentose sugar as deoxyribose, and ribonucleic acid has a pentose sugar of ribose. Now DNA consists as pyrimidine bases as cytosine and thymine. In RNA, this thymine has been replaced by uracil here. So the pyrimidine bases present on RNA is your cytosine and uracil. However, the purine bases are same in both. It can replicate itself. We have seen there by the process of replication, a single DNA can form the two DNA molecule, and it can be replicated, cannot be replicated by RNA molecule. Therefore, it has been synthesizing from DNA. It is a genetic material of the eukaryotic cell, whereas this is the genetic material of your plant virus. Now there comes another term known as mutation. Mutation is a chemical change in DNA molecules that could lead to the synthesis of protein with an altered sequence of amino acid. For example, if the DNA base sequence changes somehow, okay, and this will result in the synthesis of different amino acid, resulting in the formation of different protein. That process is known as mutation. So here your nucleic acids also completes.